Every once in a while, babies are born with some organs on the outside instead of the inside. It sounds crazy, but it's true, and it's happening more now than ever before. Hey guys, what's up? I'm Supna, here for D News. About one out of every 2,000 babies is born with a deformity where their intestines are outside the body. This condition is called gastroschisis. That's from the Greek word for belly cleft. Believe it or not, many of these babies survive because soon after they're born, surgeons often perform a corrective procedure to place the intestines back into the body. But it's not always easy because these organs are outside the skin. They're exposed to the elements, so they're usually inflamed and swollen. And also, these infants have only developed tiny bellies since their organs weren't inside. That means the surgery is often done in stages. One, to ensure that they can get everything back in, and two, to give the baby the best possible chance for recovery. Gastroschisis occurs because some babies are born with a hole right next to their belly button. And to understand why that happens, we have to look at what's going on in the womb when an embryo first develops the abdominal wall. So at about 3.5 weeks, an embryo's digestive tract starts to form. At 6 weeks, it starts to lengthen. And by 10 weeks, the digestive tract and all the major organs are encapsulated by the abdominal cavity, and then the layers of the abdominal wall seal everything off. And that last part is the stage where things can go wrong. There are a bunch of different theories about exactly how things go wrong, but the majority of scientists believe it's something called the vascular disruption theory. Essentially, it's the idea that there's not enough blood flow to the abdominal layers. The lack of blood supplying the abdominal tissues as they form leaves a weak spot that can end up rupturing. This creates a hole right next to the fetus's umbilical cord. And if that hole is big enough, the liver, spleen, and other organs can end up on the exterior of the baby's body also. When all these organs end up on the outside, it's called an omphalocele, and that occurs in about one out of every 4,000 births. It's also possible for the bladder and even the heart to end up on the outside, but that is much more rare. What causes these birth defects isn't fully understood yet, but we do have some clues. Researchers think it could be genetic, and they found it happens more often in young mothers, women with poor nutrition, and women who smoke, do drugs, or consume alcohol. And there's even research showing links to aspirin intake and exposure to certain chemicals. More research is obviously needed, and the research can't come soon enough. A recent report from the CDC says the number of babies born with gastroschisis, where the intestines are outside, has been going up around the world since the 1980s. According to the CDC, this is an urgent wake-up call. If we know more about what causes it, then we can figure out how to stop it. Have you ever wondered why some organs come in pairs, but others don't? To find out why, click on this video.
Evolutionary anthropologists guess that we have two limbs, two lungs, and two kidneys because we need them for some reason. They're not spare parts, but instead, the dual organs gave ancestral organisms an advantage in some way.
And do you have any cool medical science questions you want us to answer? Tell me down in the comments section below, and don't forget to click subscribe. We have episodes of D News for you every single day.